Let us start with application part of Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law, which we studied in previous lecture. As per KCL, we know that algebraic sum of all the current at any junction is always equal to zero. To use this law, we consider two sign convention. Incoming currents are positive and outgoing currents are negative. Remember, very important. Similarly, Kirchhoff's voltage law states that algebraic sum of electromotive forces and algebraic sum of product of current and resistors or any closed loop is always equal to zero. Now similarly, to apply KVL, we use two sign convention. For EMF, EMF of cell is taken as positive while going through loop when moves from negative side to positive side, and EMF is considered to be negative while going from positive side to negative side. Similarly, for this product IR, current is taken as positive when today current positive when it flows in the opposite direction of loop, and current is taken as negative when it flows in the direction of loop. So already we studied in previous lecture. Now let us try to understand how exactly KCL and KVL is useful while solving electrical network or electrical circuit. Suppose we are going to consider one electrical circuit in which two batteries or two cells are connected in parallel. For example, suppose first cell is of EMF 5 volt, second cell of EMF 3 volt, with internal resistance of each cell, say it is 1 ohm. 1 ohm, here also 1 ohm. And suppose now these two cells or two batteries are connected in parallel combination. Now already in 11th standard you studied, parallel means like terminal together. When positive of first cell is connected to positive of second, plus plus, minus minus. This is first cell, this is second cell. This is called as a parallel combination of cells or batteries. Like terminal together. Simply remember, like terminal together. Similarly, sometimes cells may be given in series. When unlike terminals are together, means negative of first is connected to positive of second, then this is called as a series combination of cells or batteries. Now, for this numerical, cells are given in parallel combination, first case. And now this combination is used to pass certain current through external resistance, say R is equal to 10 ohm. And now we have to solve this circuit. We have to solve this circuit, means what to do? We have to calculate current flowing through different branches. Means how much current is drawn from first cell, how much current is drawn from second cell and through external resistance. Actually, while solving these numericals, be careful. Circuit diagram will not be provided. By using this data, you have to construct circuit diagram. So we'll start. Now these two cells are given in parallel combination. So imagine this is first cell with internal resistance R1. These are the two polarities, positive negative, EMF suppose E1. Now it is connected in parallel with second cell. This is second cell of EMF E2, positive negative. Now its internal resistance, let it be R2. So these two are in connected parallel combination. Now across this combination, an external resistance, suppose capital R, is connected. You just imagine this is external resistance capital R. So by knowing this data, we constructed this circuit. Now when we just remember, we will consider later after application. Now here, all the junction points, first of all you have to label. In entire circuit, I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 junctions are there. So A, B, C, D, E and F. These are the total 6 junctions which label for this entire circuit. Now, you have to assume the flow of current through different branches. We know that general trend is that current is drawn from positive and again comes to the negative terminal. So from this first cell, we will assume a current of I1 ampere. From second cell, we assume current of I2. Now this I2 via this branch, both combine at the junction. And suppose total current I ampere flows through this external resistance. Now this I ampere, again at E junction, it is divided into branches. Now one general rule, whatever current is drawn from positive, same current is returned to its negative. So through this branch, again I1 current should flow. And remaining I2 current, it will return to negative of this second cell. So this is the circuit which you have to construct. Will not be provided with statement. Be careful. Now we have to solve this circuit. Means what to do? We have to calculate current flowing through each cell. first cell current is I1, through second cell current is I2, and third requirement current through external resistance, which we assume as a capital I. These are the three requirements. So to solve this problem, we can't use Ohm's law because it is a complicated or complex electrical network. So in order to get these requirements, we are going to apply KCL and KVL. So first of all, for junction B or E, for junction B, using Kirchhoff's current law, KCL. What is statement of KCL? Sum of incoming current equal to sum of outgoing current, or algebraic sum of current at any junction is zero. So there are two currents, I1 and I2, approaching to a junction. I be the current going away from the junction. So as per KCL, we can write I1 plus I2 equals to capital I. Equation number first, very very important. Is it clear? Now, in this equation there are three unknown, I1, I2, I. So only one equation and three unknown, we will not get solution. Minimum two more equations will be required. So how to get two more equations? We have one more law, that is KVL. So KVL is applicable for any closed loop. Now in this entire circuit there are three possible closed loop, A, B, C, D, E of A, this outer one. Direction doesn't matter, clockwise you make start anti-clockwise. A of E, D, C, B, A. As it is a first numerical, we will consider in a clockwise direction. Suppose for closed loop, which closed loop? Yes, A, B, C, D, E of A. Using, yes, Kirchhoff's voltage law, KVL. We have to apply KVL. What is KVL? Sigma E means algebraic sum of electromotive forces. Sigma E plus sigma IR is equal to zero. So this is the first loop which we consider. Two more loops are there. One is internal A, B, E, E of A, and second one B, C, D, E, B. We consider later. So first of all, for this outer loop, we will apply KVL. How to apply KVL? First of all, try to get sigma E. Start with A point. Sigma E exists when cell is there. A to B, any cell is there? Absolutely no. B to C, no. C to D, again no cell. D to E, no cell. E to F, no cell. F to A, yes, cell is there. How much is EMF? E2. So we will get here E2. Question are whether to take positive or negative sign convention. What is that? While going from negative side to positive side, that EMF is taken as positive. So plus E2. So this part is over now. Now start for the second part, sigma R. Again start with same point, A to B. Now this product will exist if resistance is there. In this branch, no resistance. This branch, no resistance. This branch, resistance is there. So product will be IR. Is it clear? Now, what about sign plus or minus? It will be decided by sign convention. Here current and loop direction is same. Loop direction is C to D. Current is also in same direction. And therefore, we have to consider as a minus. Next part, D to E, no resistance. E to F, no resistance. F to A, yes. So product will be I2R2. Whether to take positive or negative here? Yes, negative. Why? Because current direction and loop direction same. And as per the law, this must be equal to 0. Now, if we simplify substituting values, so we can write here, take on this side, I from equation 1, we can write I1 plus I2. I1 plus I2. R is given as a 10, so 10. This is plus, R2 is 1, so I2 will be equal to E2. What is value of E2 we consider? It is 3 volt. Is it clear? Now, simplifying this equation. What will be equation? Yes, tell me equation. We will get equation number 2. What will be that equation? 10 I1. Yes. Next, this 10 I2 and this I2 plus 11 I2 will be equal to 3. Equation number 2. This is by using Kirchhoff voltage law. Now, equation first, equation second. Till we will require one more equation. So what to do? Consider one more closed loop. Which closed loop now we can consider? Let us consider now second one, inner closed loop. A of E, B, A. First we consider clockwise, now we consider anti-clockwise. Doesn't matter. You can consider any direction with any one starting point. So A of E, B, A. A of E, B, A. for this closed loop, again apply KVL. So using KVL, what will be equation? Here start V first, sigma E. Start with A to F, yes, EMF E2. Whether to take positive or negative? Obvious, we are moving from positive side to negative, so it must be minus. F to E, no cell. E to B, yes, cell. And EMF is E1. So as per sign convention, it will be positive. Why positive? Because we are going from negative side to positive side across that cell. Hence, as per sign convention, it is positive. B to A, no cell. So sigma E part is O. Now start for sigma IR. What to do? Again start with A. A to F, resistance, yes, R2. So product will be I2 R2. Whether to take positive or negative? Sure, positive. Why? Because loop direction is A to F and current direction is F to A. Current flows in the opposite direction of loop, hence it is positive. Next, F to E, no resistance. E to B, yes, R1. So product will be I1 R1. Product will be I1 R1. Whether to take positive or negative? Negative. Why negative? Loop direction and current direction are same, hence it is negative. And no resistance, hence loop is completed, this must be equal to 0. Now if we simplify it, what will be equation? Yes? No, let us see. I2, R2, R2 is 1, I1 is also 1. Now if we take this term on this side, entire both this term, if we take on right side, then R1 means I1, this is minus I2, will be equal to. Now this will remain as it is. E1 we consider as a 5, E2 3. So it will be 5 minus 3, that comes out equal to 2. So simply we can write here, I1 minus I2 is equal to 2. Equation number 3. Now see here. Equation 1 using KCL, I1 plus I2 is equal to I. By considering outer closed loop using KVL, we got second equation, 10I1 plus 11I2 is equal to 3. And using KVL again for inner closed loop, AFEBA, we got third equation. Now, three unknown, three equations, solve simultaneously. So, what to do? Now, second equation and third equation, if you observe, equation number 3 multiplied by 11 plus equation number 2. What this operation gives? Here, see here. 11I1 minus 11I2 will be equal to 22. Now, here, 10I1 plus 11I2 will be equal to 3. If you take addition, these two parts get cancelled. So 21I1 will be equal to 25. And that gives very, very important deduction. What will be that deduction? We will get the first requirement of the circuit. Current flowing through first cell comes out equal to 25 divided by 21 ampere. Very, very important. Once you get this first value, use it either in second or third equation. I think third equation will be preferable. So we will get I2. So what to do? Just tell me. I1 replace as 25 by 21 minus I2 will be equal to 2. Just exchange these values. Minus 2 is equal to I2. So I2 comes out equal to, if we take LCM, 25 minus 42 divided by 21. And that gives value of I2. What will be I2? I2 is equal to, what will be difference? I think minus 17 divided by 21 ampere. Minus 17 divided by 21 ampere. Very, very important. Now, once you get I1 and I2, just recall equation number first. What is equation number first? Yes, I is equal to I1 plus I2. And that gives the third requirement, total current, 25 divided by 21 plus minus 17 by 21. And that gives total current is equal to, 8 divided by 21 ampere. Very, very, very important. So in this way, by using KCL and KVL, we can solve the circuit. We got all the three requirements, I1, I2 and I. But if you observe these two values, I1 is positive. Means this assumed direction, when you get solution positive, assumed direction is correct. Means current through this cell flows in same direction. As I2 we got negative, only remember, not to make changes in circuit now. Only negative sign implies that current through second cell flows in reverse direction. How is it possible? Actually in a combined circuit,
a greater EMF cell reverses current in a smaller EMF cell. Here E1 is greater, E2 is greater. Hence current through second cell reverses. Hence we got here negative solution. So this is application part of KCL and KVL. Now similar type of problem I will put for homework. You just go through it, and if you arrive any difficulty, you can contact me.